Hey gang, Ross Brand here for livestreamuniverse.com. We are live on the red carpet at Mario Armstrong's Never Settle Show, getting you ready for episode 3 coming up at 7 p.m. Eastern. At 7 p.m., you're going to head on over to the Entrepreneur Facebook page where Mario will be live. He's going to be talking today about sharing his proven formula. It's a proven formula for asking and receiving. It's going to be how to do a successful ask, and that's going to be coming up at 7 p.m. Eastern. He's also going to have a mime on who's going to tell you a little bit about how to do storytelling. Maybe without talking, maybe with talking, we will find out. And then a former lead designer at Nike, Jason Maiden, will be our primary guest coming up on the show. And here we have
What's up, Ross?
Main attraction, Mr. Mario Armstrong.
No, the people are the main attraction. You guys that are watching, you guys that support the show, you guys that show up and be great guests, you guys are the main attraction. I can't thank you all enough. I'm in the middle of like a clothing change. I don't know how this show has turned into me changing clothes like all the time, like on camera, from pajamas to clothes.
I don't know. Look better, like, well, you dress better for rehearsal than most people do for the main event.
I'll absorb that one.
So now,
Claudia, what's up?
Hey.
Julie and the whole crew. Claudia is amazing. Did you know that Anna, what's happening? Anna. So good to see you guys. Did you know that Claudia did a whole thing on Periscope?
Oh yeah. Day before.
Do you know how lost Shy and I were? Because we were so in the weeds with the show.
We were a little bit busy.
Oh my God, we were so nervous. We didn't know.
It was great.
We thought someone was hijacking the hashtag.
No.
We were like, who hijacked our hashtag?
No, she brought together music artists from all over the world.
Once I started watching a few of the scopes, I was like, oh, I get it now. It's all real music festival.
Yeah.
On this show. It was the most amazing piece of support that I saw, and I was just like, wow.
Awesome.
We just wanted to let you know. I'll never forget that, Claudia. That was amazing.
Claudia also did a rap pitch, so.
I haven't seen.
She's a talented singer. I've never heard her rap.
Wait, where's the rap pitch? Did she send it in?
I don't know.
We haven't gotten your rap pitch.
Tell us where it is, Claudia.
We didn't see that. Where is it? Did you hashtag it? Never Settle Show? You were supposed to hashtag it. I haven't seen it. We were looking for rap pitches like 2 hours ago.
Check it out. Okay.
Where? Tell me where. I need that, like yesterday.
So you're going to talk about the big ask.
Yeah, that's going to be
and
one
I'm
of the things.
I'm trying to make sure I don't hit the wrong syllable on that, or that sounds wrong, right?
The big ask.
You got a method, right?
Yeah.
For when you need to get something that you really want.
Yeah, I did it with, I'll show this in more detail, but I did it with Matt Lauer, and that was like my ultimate test. And when I realized that this formula that I kind of like stumbled into and crafted on that worked several times since then, I was like, people need to try this out. If they're hitting bumps in the road, if they're hitting roadblocks, people need to try this out. So I'll be sharing those three tips. Our guest is going to share a ton of tips.
Right.
I mean, this guy is the guy that was a former lead designer at Nike.
Wow.
So he worked on everything from the Jordan line to some others. So he can talk about creativity, innovation, but also how did he break into Nike is a really awesome story. But not only that, he also has now left Nike to take care of his kid and his family and started his own startup and got $1.75 million in venture capital for his startup. So he's got a lot of exposure and a lot of lessons to learn.
So you're a never settle kind of person.
Yes.
You definitely want to check him out.
Yeah, he's going to be awesome. Who else is coming by the show?
You got a mime.
Oh, yeah, we do.
Is she going to talk, or is she going to do it all in mime?
So, Kathy Nolan, who is our illustrious illustrator and artist, won't be here this week because she's on vacation with family. So, I said, we got to do something different. So, we brought in a mime. And a mime has the artistic ability to tell a story through gestures and without words.
Okay.
So what I wanted to see, this is an experiment of live. I wanted to see what's it going to be like to have a mime use their art to gesture what they're hearing from the interview.
Oh, wow.
So it's just a different form of drawing or artistry.
That is awesome.
So I'm looking forward to that.
I can't wait.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that. Okay, so she said it's on Facebook. Okay, Rap
Pitch.
Facebook. Okay.
Buddy Santiago official videos.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, we got to check that. All right. See, the problem with Facebook might be sometimes we can't find everything through Facebook. Twitter and Instagram are much easier because some of the security settings sometimes blocks out the ability.
And you can
to
just
get
search
it.
The hashtag and then you see all of them.
All right. Oh, it's on IG. Okay. Boom, done. And Twitter? What? Claudia, you're lying. She's really? Hashtag rap pitch? Hashtag rap pitch. We'll go find this right away.
All right.
I'm going to see if we can
I'll let you go get ready.
I'm going to see if we can get this into
Looking
the show.
I got to
go.
The show.
Thanks for holding
that. That is Mario Armstrong. He's going to be the host 7 p.m. Eastern. You want to head on over to the Entrepreneur Facebook page. That's where Mario will be live with the Never Settle Show presented by FedEx Office. And if you see behind us, it's the Step and Repeat. And you can see the different sponsors of the show. You have Entrepreneur Magazine, Canary, the folks who provided this great building, and FedEx Office. And in fact, we want to tell you about a special offer that FedEx Office has. You can get $30 off your first order, and you can also get free shipping on up to $100 on I think in any order over $100. Anyway, check it out online. Just go to Never Settle Show on Facebook, hashtag Never Settle Show or at Never Settle Show. Lots of great offers there. Of course, you see Roker Media behind us, the co-producers of the event. And another sponsor that we would love to talk to is Root Studios. And coming in, doing the photography today is Alex. Hey, Alex.
Yes, hi,
thanks for joining us. Tell everybody what Root Studios is, what you guys do.
Root Studios is a professional photo studio. We have rental spaces, we do events, and we have professional photo equipment and video equipment.
So we have a lot of live streamers who watch this pre-show here from the red carpet. And last week, Ro was nice enough to give us some pointers about how to take still photography, how to take still pictures on the red carpet. Can you give us some tips on doing live streams, kind of like the selfie? Like, and you can use me as an example and just show, like, okay, how do you hold the right angle for taking, whether you're on a red carpet, whether you're walking down the street, whatever you think.
I think, well, there are a couple of things that can really help you. One is your angle. What you want to do is you want to raise it and you want to find exactly which side is your best side. Which
side? My good side.
Yeah, which side is your good side? Beautiful. Okay. That's great. And then the next thing.
So that means like I should send you to stand over there. So I'm always getting my good side.
Much better. Oh, okay.
Right. So that's like when I see a sitcom and the news reporter, like, get me from my good side, right? That's what that's about. Okay. So now I want to hold it higher.
Yeah, so you want to hold it higher?
Higher than my eye level.
Yes. Now I'm a little shorter, so there we go.
And do I still? Yeah, that's. And so, where do I want to be looking? As like, I have a phone in my hand. I'm using a tripod because the folks can't see exactly what I'm doing. But where do I want to be looking when I'm looking at the camera?
You want to be looking at the lens. You want to keep looking at the lens, but at the same time, you don't want people.
So
to feel
the
like
lens
staring
is going
to
be
them.
In here somewhere.
Yeah, yeah.
So I want to be looking at that lens.
Right. And the other thing too, which you can't always control, is lighting. You really want to have soft, even lighting. That's what's going to be the most flattering, especially the video where you can't really, you know, you can't edit it like you can with a still image, not as easily as you can. So you really want to have nice, soft, even lighting, which is kind of what our photo booth does.
Right. And so when people come to take pictures in the photo booth, now that's still photography.
That's still photography.
Do you have any pointers for still photography for people who are coming up and they want to get their glamour shot on the red carpet? What should we do?
I think a lot of those pointers for video really do, they work for still as well. But I think the main thing is to, you know, to have your pose ready, but also don't look too overposed. You want to keep it natural.
Right,
that's the worst thing that you can do is like make it look too unnatural. And it's hard. It's hard when you're, you know, standing in front of a booth, you're at an event. But if you really want a good photo, you just want to have fun with it.
Thank you so much, Alex. Where can we find you guys on social?
You can find us on social at Root Studios, and you can go to our website at rootnyc.com.
Awesome. Thank you so much. So I'm going to turn the camera around, or just turn myself around, actually, so you can see this big studio space. The building is, or the venue here is presented by Canary. Canary is a startup strike a pose. Julie, thank you. So Canary is a startup, and they help you keep your home safe. Basically, it's digital equipment. It has video that's on in your home, and you can access that from wherever you are. So if anybody breaks in, or if you just want to keep an eye on things, you can do that with the equipment from Canary. So Canary, one of the sponsors, and they are providing this great set. I am going to turn now and just show you the set. The people are not yet, have not yet filed in. And Kathy Nolan, not here today. This is Kathy's normal spot, but she's away today. And in her place is going to be a mime. The mime is going to actually tell the story non-verbally by doing her thing. I don't know, doing her miming, I guess you would call it. But this is Kathy's drawing from last week, from episode 2. Can you believe that we're already up to episode 3? After today's show, we'll be halfway through season 1 of the Never Settle show, and it's been a success so far. About 220,000 views for the first 2 episodes, so the Never Settle show is off to a strong start. And they moved the bar this week. I'm going to walk on over and show you. The bar is on the opposite side of the set this week, and there is the Never Settle Show bar. Our bartender is Berlin Kelly from Proud Pour, and you can see she's got both red and white wines, and her wines, all the profits, or the different, some of the profits I should say, go to support the environment. And you can see here the bookshelf. Let me back out a little bit here. You can see the bookshelf here on the set, and one of the things, of course, that attracts your eye if you haven't seen it before is Mario's Emmy Award. 2010 Emmy Award for a piece he did on You Can Afford College on Maryland Public Television. So you have that there. And one of our good friends has a book here on the set. It's Chris Strub's book, 50 States, 100 Days, the book. You probably saw Chris wrap his pitch. Also, the book Two Awesome Hours by Josh Davis is here as well. And of course, we have a copy of Entrepreneur Magazine. Entrepreneur is one of the sponsors of the Never Settle Show. And at 7 o'clock, of course, you're going to head on over to Entrepreneur Facebook page, facebook.com/ENT Magazine, to watch the show at 7 p.m. Eastern. And again, we have Canary. This is what the Canary devices look like. They will keep your home safe, keep you appraised of everything going on via video. And in fact, if something cool happens when you're not home and you have a Canary device, go ahead and upload that to YouTube and get some views. Pretty cool. Chris Strub asks, what color kicks is Mario wearing? You know, I don't know. I do not know. You can see some of the kicks, though, that he has here. These are quite bright.
Wait, I got something for you to tell Chris about the sneakers.
Okay.
Some week.
Hey, we got a guest joining us right now. It is co-executive producer Shai.
What's up, everyone? So, what's Chris, the thing about the sneakers this week is we're actually going to do a poll in the first couple minutes of the show. And you're going to choose what sneakers she's going to wear. There's going to be 2 choices.
Oh, wow.
It's going to be a pair of Nikes and a pair of Adidas. We're going to show them both to you. We'll let the audience decide, and then Mario's going to put on whichever one wins the poll.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah. I think it's going to be fun.
So
it's a little different.
While you're here, let me ask you. First week was amazing, right?
Thanks.
Last week's show, even better. I mean, it was just flowed so
cool.
Smooth,
I'm so
right?
Glad you think so, yeah.
But what I figured, you know, there's probably going to be a little bit of a drop-off from the first week to the second week in terms of views, because
right.
Everybody wants to see the new thing, right?
Sure, yeah.
But in fact, the views were almost identical. What do you account for the fact that it was such a strong turnout for the second show?
There were a couple of things that happened this week that I thought were really interesting. I was at a barbecue on Saturday with a bunch of young professionals who live in Brooklyn,
right.
You know, late 20s, early 30s. And I was talking to my show about the show to somebody, and somebody was like, oh yeah, I saw that. Mm-hmm. And I was like, no, you didn't. You think you saw something else. You didn't see our show. But then she got to talking about what she had seen. I was like, oh, no, you watched my show.
Right.
I don't think you saw enough of it to recognize me as a social media guy, but she actually had watched some of it.
Right, right.
And then Mario was telling me he had an encounter with somebody at the pet store. He was taking a cello to get groomed earlier today. And the guy working at the pet store was like, oh, yeah, the Never Settle Show, I know that. And Mario was like, had the same thing. He's like, no, you don't. You don't know anything about it. He's right, like, no, I watched it last week. There was that couple, from Jamaica or whatever. Right. And he's like, wait a minute. So,
wow.
You know, I think the thing is that after the first episode, what's happening is that the word is starting to get out. People are starting to talk about it. It's starting to make its way around Facebook. It is shared on social media. And so I think people who we don't even know, you know, it's like started from this small community where you could probably name me everyone who watches your average, you know, Mario Armstrong Periscope or Mario Armstrong Facebook Live broadcast to a point where we're reaching new audiences and as word spreads, I think maybe that helped prevent some of that drop-off.
And I think for a lot of us who enjoy doing live streaming, that's what our big hope for this show is that it will help live streaming break out to a wider audience beyond people who are live streamers or enthusiasts about consuming live stream content.
And what I hope is when you tell people, oh, I've got a live show on Facebook, they'll know what you're talking about because they will have seen an example of something like that before. Maybe it's our show, maybe it's somebody else's show, but that, you know, it won't be a thing you have to explain every time you try to talk about it to somebody who maybe hasn't watched something like that before. You know, hopefully our show will be, you know, if it's the first thing that they watch and then they want to go check out other streams, I think that's fantastic. I mean, that's a huge win for everybody.
That's awesome. Anything stand out from social media last week that you figured, wow, this is a memory or this is something that was different from the first week?
What I thought was so cool was, so the first week we had the poll for who Kathy Nolan, the cartoonist, should draw.
Right.
And the woman overwhelmingly won.
Right.
And so I don't really remember. It was like a man and a woman who the poll was to choose between. And what I saw happening in the comments, people were like, well, we picked a woman last time. You know, like, overwhelmingly. So let's try to see if we can get the guy to win this week.
And he did.
And he did. you know, so to see, like, the community and the chat come together to talk about something, to come to a conclusion, and then to actually get the votes to make it happen.
Right.
I thought that was really cool.
And you know, it was a great moment when the woman from the audience connected with the boxing coach.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Identified with her story. Now, I think she was the one who was drawn by Kathy the first week.
She was,
right?
Yeah, she's like coming every week.
From the audience, playing a guest star role each week.
Yeah, yeah, it's cool.
Wow, so anything to keep our eye on for social this week? Anything you're looking for in terms of people's reaction?
Well, I think that the voting for the sneakers is going to be cool. There's going to be another poll kind of later in the show that should be really fun. But the thing that we're going to do this week that's going to be totally different is we've got, on top of me and Evie, we've got a couple people at home who are also going to be watching the Facebook Live comments.
Nice.
And they're going to be basically alerting us if we miss something that they think is good. So, you know, with the, how many comments are coming in, you know, having more people reading them all and being like, oh, this is a great comment is, I think, really going to help us every time Mario turns to us have, oh, we got the right comment for this situation.
And everybody should use hashtag NeverSettleShow on every tweet, Instagram,
absolutely
post,
everything,
Facebook.
And we'll, that's the stuff that we'll be able to get up onto these TVs.
Awesome. Come on in, Nicole. No?
She's still getting her hair did.
All right.
I'm going to bounce.
Great. Ross. Thank you, Shai.
So that's co-executive producer Shai. He's going to be manning social media along with Evie Y, and we'll talk to Evie hopefully in a little bit. She is up for YouNow Performer of the Year, and she's going to be attending the Shorty Awards on Sunday. Also, of course, a shout out to Leslie Nance, who's been a big member of our community, and she is up for Periscoper of the Year at the Shorty Awards on Sunday. So that's going to be fun. And that was hey, April. April says hi, Nicole. Nicole is the CEO of the Never Settle Show Productions and Mario Armstrong Productions, and she is obviously very busy, but we're really thankful for the opportunity that she's provided for us to do this red carpet show and to give you all a taste of what's going on behind the scenes here at Canary. And again, some great segments tonight to look forward to. If you're just joining us at 7 p.m. Eastern, you want to head on over to the Entrepreneur Facebook page. facebook.com/ENT Magazine, 7 p.m. Eastern, the show starts. There's going to be a mime, the former lead designer for Nike involved with Air Jordans and their major campaigns is going to be a guest. Mario's also going to give some tips about how to ask and receive. When you need that big ask, how do you go about doing that? He's going to give you a formula that can't miss. And behind me, you can see the work of caricaturist Kathy Nolan. She's not here this week. She'll be back next week, but you can see behind her, behind us, her great work is on display. And Chris asked about Proud Poor is here. The bar is on the opposite side today, Chris, and we will introduce you to Berlin Kelly or check in with her if you've spoken, if you've seen her before, but she's busy at the moment. And where I'm standing is kind of where Mario will be doing the interviews from. You can see there's a social media board behind me on one side, and then the Never Settle show. You have, let me just lower this a little bit. You can see the interview chairs. I'll go out and I'll turn it around. Easy for you. That's easier. So this is like the main part of the set where Mari does the interviews, but he spends a lot of his time out in the audience, really interacting with people and taking questions and keeping the energy high. But when he does do the interviews with his guests, this is where the guest sits, and this is the background. And Chris Strub says he's home tonight because he did Mitch Jackson's The Show Not Live with Jenny Q. Hope that went well. Hope everybody's doing well and enjoying all their live streaming shows today as we get you set for the Never Settle Show. Mario Armstrong and company coming up at 7 p.m. Eastern here on Facebook Live. It'll be on the Entrepreneur Facebook page, ENT Magazine, facebook.com/ENT Magazine. And the people have asked for Billy and Proud Poor, so I have to oblige. I don't know whether you're ready at the moment,
sure.
But you would love to come on camera and say a quick hello to all our friends.
Hi.
On Facebook Live on the Never Settle Show Facebook page.
Yep.
And just tell us real quick about Proud Poor for some new people joining us this week.
Cool. So I started this company, Proud Poor, to fix environmental issues. So every bottle of this wine is going to restore 100 oysters to New York Harbor. And that is super important because we used to have trillions of oysters in New York Harbor and they're totally wiped out. One oyster cleans 30 gallons of water per day. Also, they rebuild reefs, which are like coral reefs, so these habitats. And these reefs also prevent flooding from things like Hurricane Sandy. So we can not have flooding, we can have clean water, we can have local food, like all sorts of awesome things. And then this wine is a delicious, sustainably grown wine, and it's got no acid, no sugar, nothing added. It's just Sauvignon Blanc. Secret of the Napa Valley wineries is that they put a whole bunch of sugar in their wines illegally. Right. We don't do that. So, yeah.
Now, I'm going to guess from the accent you're not from New York, right?
I'm not from New York. No.
So what made you take up the cause of the oysters in New York?
I was living in New York. I was drinking. And I wanted to connect with the environment, and in New York we have very little connection to our environment, and I think a lot of that's due to the fact that we don't have a ton of wild environment right here. Like in California, you have like hiking trails and trees and mountains and beaches. Here we don't have a lot of that, and it's just because it's become polluted. But it is here, so just wanting to bring that back.
That's awesome. Well, thanks for coming over to New York City and making us have a better environment. We appreciate it.
Well,
Berlin Kelly, it's Proud Poor, and where can we find you online again?
Proudpoor.com, www.proudpoor.com.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks.
So the crowd will be filing in soon. Chris and everybody, hope you enjoyed seeing Berlin Kelly from Proud Poor. So we take a look around, see who else is hanging out. So we get set for the show. We'll begin at 7 p.m. Eastern on the Entrepreneur Facebook page, ENT Magazine, facebook.com/ENT Magazine. Anissa. Hi. I know your name. I was just going to say somebody who's behind the camera most of the time.
Hi.
But it's great to have you joining us. How did and you're the supervising producer for the Never Settle show.
Yes.
And Anissa makes so much happen behind the scenes. I felt like we got to talk to her on camera and give her some props. So you're doing an awesome job with this.
Thank you.
Talk about how you got to know Mario and how this all came together.
So I've been working with Mario and Nicole for 10 years, and it's been such an awesome journey to watch them put this dream together and actually make it happen. We worked on an AOL project back in the day where it was a little bit ahead of its time, where it was actually like a YouTube personal upload user scenario. So that's how ahead of the time that we did a project back in the day together.
Wow. And so you came in from Las Vegas,
yes,
to work on this. Talk about a little bit about what you do out in Las Vegas.
So I have a production company in Las Vegas, and I call my team the Jedi because I got an awesome team. We do everything from corporate to reality shows to commercials, short form programming, and that's how we do it. We just get, you know, stuff thrown our way, and we figure out if we like the project or not.
Now, did you bring any team members with you?
I did. Gina, she came with me. She is an awesome producer, and we just dance when we work together.
Right, right.
So,
now, did you ever work on a live stream show before?
I have, actually, with Mari and Nicole. We did it years ago.
Okay.
I've done a couple live stream shows with guests and, you know, live packages, you name it. It's been interesting to see the dream form into this. I'm really excited for that.
What surprised you the most about how things have gone the first couple weeks?
You know, there's a lot of elements, and you know, when you see credits roll on a TV show or a movie, you know, it's like, wow, it takes that many people to put it on, and it really does. And even on this small crew, so many people wearing so many different hats, there's a lot of chaos.
Right.
Good chaos, but there's a lot of stuff that needs to be done, so we're getting ready to load in the audience, so that's what's happening.
So thank you so much for all you do on the show, and it's so great to talk to you on camera.
Thanks for us.
Yep. That's Anissa. She's the supervising producer of The Never Settle Show. The Never Settle Show airs at 7 p.m. Eastern, and we have another special guest
that's
just coming in one by one.
I was
one.
Eating and I forgot.
And
I didn't even keep
you're
track
here.
Of the time.
You're here.
I'm here.
And so
what's
we
up,
have
you guys?
Evie joining us. We're live on the Never Settle Show Facebook page.
Oh, nice.
Getting set for the big show tonight.
Hey, hey.
And one of the things I wanted to ask you about. Big event coming up.
I know.
And not just talking about tonight's show, which of course is an awesome event.
Yep.
But you yourself are up for YouNower of the Year at the Shorty Award. Two awards.
Yeah, I'm a finalist for YouNower of the Year, and I'm a finalist for Best Use of YouNow against like America's Got Talent, IMG Models.
Wow, you're a big star.
Yeah.
I should
show.
I should be far more nervous interviewing you.
No.
Wow. So, you have about 2 million followers.
No, I wish 2 million followers. Oh my God. One day. No, I have 180,000 followers. I have over 10 million views.
Okay, 10 million
yeah, 10
views.
Million,
I knew there was a million in there somewhere.
Tens of millions.
So you know, we have a lot of live streamers that watch the pre-show and. What advice would you give to people who are just getting into live streaming or who maybe kind of want to ramp up and try and get all those followers?
Honestly, I do have three points of advice,
okay.
And it's just what helped me. Actually, four.
Four.
One is be consistent. Whenever you want to go live, like, if you're going to go live once a week, go live at the same time once a week. If you're going to go live twice, three times a week, commit to that and keep going live that. I commit it to every single day.
Right.
So I go live every single day at 5 p.m. no matter what. Although, it's past 5 p.m. now. But anyways, this is an exception. I'll go live now after this. But, be consistent.
Right.
And my second thing is, collaborate. Collaborate with people that have the same amount of following as you, have a little bit more, so you guys can even have a little bit less, so you can share in audiences. And then my third one is you got to be creative. Like, if you're not doing something creative or entertaining on your live stream and you're just sitting there talking to a camera, I mean, make sure if you're doing that, it's something interesting. You got to be creative. So consistency, creativity, and collaboration. And then the fourth one is just to be yourself, because people can, it's live. People can tell if you are faking it. People can see in genuine, something that's not genuine, you know. So just be yourself, and if you're boring, be 1,000 times yourself. So
be exceptionally boring. Go over the top being boring.
Yeah, hey, that could be a thing, you know. If you're boring and all you want to do is eat cereal, then every day at, you know, 10 a.m., eat a bowl of cereal, and people will tune in just to see what will happen. They'll be curious.
Right, right.
So, yeah, one time I set my live stream on my mouse trap because there was a mouse in my apartment, and I was so scared. I set the live stream on my mouse trap.
You probably got a ton of views.
All night. I woke up with 100,000 views.
Wow.
It was insane. There were thousands of people watching at 3 in the morning from different time zones. It was insane. It was insane.
Oh, that is awesome.
Yeah.
So, you're not the only one from Roker Media who's up for a Shorty Award.
No, I'm not, of course.
There's some other guy named Al.
My boss, Al Roker.
Now, is it going to be tough, like, if you won and he didn't win? I mean, like, are you going to, like, be able to show up for work on Monday?
I think so. He's got, like, 4 or 5 Emmys on me, so if I get the Shorty Award, I'll have one on him.
Only 4 or 5.
I'm always trying to steal his Emmys. It's kind of an ongoing joke.
Well, congratulations,
and
it's going to be a fun night at the Shorty Awards, and good luck. Maybe win one or two, you know?
Hopefully both, yes. I'll also be hosting the red carpet, so.
Oh, awesome.
And I'll be taking everybody backstage as well.
Cool.
So I'll be doing all that on YouNow.
Awesome.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Thanks for joining us.
No problem, no problem.
So that's Evie Y. Find her at Evie YWHY.live. She is a major YouNow influencer, also works for Roker Media. Roker Media, one of the co-producers of the show. She'll be doing social media during the show and corresponding. She also does a live pre-show. So Evie Y, a major player in the live streaming world, up for 2, not just 1, 2 Shorty Awards at this weekend's Shorty Awards Sunday night. And the crew from Canary is setting up. I want to show you quickly. Can we chat with you for a second about Canary?
Yeah.
So Canary is one of the sponsors, and they provide this great venue that the Never Settle Show is using. And I'm Ross. We're doing live from the red carpet here.
Hello.
On the Never Settle Show Facebook page.
Cool.
And I'm going to guess from the shirt that perhaps you work for Canary.
I do. My name is
Stephanie. You've stolen a lot of equipment.
Right. Brought all this stuff. I do work for Canary. I'm the EA for the CEO, Adam Sager.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
So, I've been looking around at the equipment and what it does, and it's amazing. Can you talk a little bit about some of the different ways that people use Canary?
Yeah, so it's a security device. We have the Canary one, and then also we have the new Flex, which is wired, and you can use not wired. And it's got a siren, so it will let you know if someone comes in the house. You can set off the siren. You can call the local police directly from the app. And you can use it to monitor your kids. I use it to monitor my dog when I'm at work, and kind of keep an eye on her and see what she's up to. So it really allows you to be connected to your home and to the people you care about.
And what happens if you, like, see an intruder in your home or something?
So if you see an intruder, you can, 1, sound the alarm, and 2, say, you know, you're on vacation in the Bahamas, you see an intruder. If you call the police, it's going to be a delay for you to call the police and then direct them to your hometown. But through the app, you can hit call the police, and it'll go right to your local police, saving that time, and they'll be there in a couple minutes to stop them.
Now, have you ever taken a video that, like, something funny happened with your dog and, like, uploaded it to YouTube or anything?
I have caught a mouse in my apartment. We were out with the dog, got a notification, saw him scurrying around, and also my husband came home to a dead bird in our apartment, and we didn't know how it got in, and we watched a video and saw it came in through the fireplace, and kind of watch that whole scene go down. So it would have been a mystery without the canary.
Entertainment.
Exactly.
So safety and entertainment.
Exactly, yes.
So thanks so much for providing this great venue
for
the
Never
Settle
Show. It's great
to
have you guys here. The show's great. We love Mario and the team.
Awesome. Thank you so much. So that is Canary, and they make the devices that keep you safe, but also could provide you entertainment if something cool happens while you're at home. Canary providing the studio where this great event's taking place. You can see behind me, still waiting for the crowd to file in, but we're getting set for the Never Settle Show, 7 p.m. Eastern on the Entrepreneur Facebook page, ENT Magazine, facebook.com/ENT Magazine, 7 p.m. Eastern. And thanks everybody for joining us. Really appreciate everybody dropping in. We're going to stay on for a little bit, so don't go anywhere. We're going to talk to some of the people as they come on up. And one of the things I'd love to ask you all to do is please do share this out. Let people know we're live. Let people know that we're introducing people who work behind the scenes, people who are on the cast. We talked to Mario earlier. We talked to Shai, the co-executive producer. We've talked to some of the sponsors. We talked to Evie Y, who's up for 2 Shorty Awards. So do please share this out and let everybody know that they can join us. We're going to be live from the red carpet for a little while longer. And Shai is back. What's going on?
I just got a quick ask.
Yes.
Maybe the people watching at home can help us out. We want to know what you're excited about for tonight's episode. And we need you to tweet or post that to Instagram with the hashtag NeverSettleShow right at the top of the show. So in under an hour, we want to highlight a couple of things that people are excited about on air. Evie's going to do it.
Oh, awesome.
So we need just like a couple of tweets with the hashtag NeverSettleShow on it. Ross, you can do it too when you get off if you want. And we're just going to feature some of those.
Just let people know what you're excited about. Hashtag NeverSettleShow.
Exactly, yep.
Twitter and Instagram.
I mean, Twitter's probably the
easiest. Twitter's the best for this, right? Yeah. You don't have to take a photo to do it.
Exactly.
All right.
Thanks.
Thank you, Shai. So we're getting ready. People are going to start filing in soon. Let's see who else is around as we get you set for the show. We told you about Canary. That is Canary. That is their nice logo. Look them up, Caught by Canary on Instagram, and just at Canary, I believe, on Twitter. We have a member of the social media team joining us. I see you. Hey, good. Delfine,
yes.
You're kind of famous in your own
internet.
Not at
all.
Tell everybody what you do on the internet. You have a website.
Yeah,
you have like a couple of different personas.
I do. I have quite a few. So I've been doing social media and marketing and a little bit of PR for a couple of years now. I do some blogging as well, some event hosting. So yeah,
right.
Kind of like here and there, everywhere, you know. Yeah, I do have a website where I have all my social media and marketing called kingdelfine.com.
Right.
And then I also have a fashion blog called thelittlemess.com. So I'm a little bit everywhere.
Yeah. Now, I want to ask you a question. We have a lot of people who watch the show who are live streamers and into video production. How do you do that, like, super sped up video where you do, like, time lapse or something?
Yeah.
How do you do that, like, when you show, like, you're putting on your makeup and it's like...
I know, right? It looks like you're going crazy and just flashing things. So, obviously, you shoot it in regular time, right?
Right.
You're not, like, sitting there, like, going crazy. So, I love to use... There's different editing software that you can use. I'm a Mac Apple girl, so I use Final Cut. Like,
okay.
Amazing. But I love iMovie as well.
Mm-hmm.
It's like the beginner's version of Final Cut. So,
right.
If you have a Mac, it comes free with it, so it's great. Or you can use Adobe Premiere as well and just speed up the time.
Which one do you use for the speeding up the time?
I use Final Cut.
Final Cut?
You can do it on all three platforms. Final Cut's just easier for me and it looks better.
Right.
All you have to do is speed up your time. So you look for the time.
And do you recommend Final Cut for people who are looking to move up from iMovie?
Yes, I do. If you're looking for something more advanced, something that can do fancier effects, then I would definitely recommend either Final Cut or Adobe Premiere. I think Final Cut's easier to learn, though.
So how's the social media going for the show so far?
It's so good. Everybody is so involved in it.
Right.
Everyone online is so engaged. It's really beautiful to see. I think everyone can kind of tell from the social that the show is for them.
Literally. Right, right.
You know, it's, the audience is made of everyday people just like you. Our guests are everyday people.
Right.
Who've been able to either leave their 9-to-5 or take it up a picking up a notch in their career, so it's really beautiful. And social, I mean, we're online talking to people all throughout the show, so Twitter's going crazy week.
Delfine, thank you
thank you.
Great
see
to talk to you.
So yeah, that's right, 7 o'clock, you head on over to the Entrepreneur Facebook page, ENT Magazine, facebook.com/ENT Magazine. At 7 p.m. Eastern, we will be live with the Never Settle Show and Mario Armstrong at 7 p.m. Eastern as we get you ready. Crowd starting to file in now. And let's see if we can grab, Ben, can we grab you for a second?
Nope.
He's swimming. He's busy. We'll show you the red carpet real quick. So if you come to the Never Settle Show, you can get your picture taken on the red carpet. And I think I see a familiar face, somebody who's not afraid to live stream.
No, I'm not afraid to live stream.
You've done a couple. I think you talk, maybe sing a little bit.
True.
Tell everybody, you know, where they can find you on Periscope and Facebook Live and all that stuff.
All right, you can find me at Azania Noah, A-Z-A-N-I-A, Noah, like Noah's Ark.
Okay, and you were here for the first show.
I was.
What,
it was awesome.
What brought you back tonight? You just enjoyed it?
Yes, I wanted to live the experience before I'm going traveling to Europe for a couple of weeks the next week, so I'm going to miss the next show.
For work?
Or yeah.
Anything you can tell us about?
I'm actually on second round of auditions for the for the Bodyguard musical.
Oh, wow.
In Paris, yeah. So that's going
like
to be...
Like the Whitney Houston, Kevin Costner?
Absolutely.
I didn't know a musical could be made from that.
Yeah,
wow,
yeah.
Look at that.
It's in London, it's in Germany, it's in the States too, actually, right now.
Wow.
Yeah.
So would you be performing in Europe, or would you be in the States too? If you
I
got
would probably
the...
be mostly in all French-speaking countries.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Because all the speaking is in French and all the singing is all in English. So,
oh, okay.
Yeah, so that's going to be fun.
Yeah, so what did you like about the first show? What stood out to you?
The first show, I mean, Mario's energy is amazing. I think that the joy in the hall was really, really palpable. Like, I mean, it's just such a great positive environment. I think we need more positive shows that uplift people, that inspire people, that, you know, really push them and encourage them to go after their dreams, and to see actual people who are living their dreams is the perfect way to do that.
Now, as a live streamer, this is obviously taking things to the next level, right? What does this mean to you to see this kind of a production and this kind of a turnout for a live stream show?
Yeah, I think it's really promising because the live streaming world, I mean, yes, it's been around for a while, but it's just taken such an incredible, like, leaps and bounds now. I mean, it's just, I think that Mario is definitely a pioneer in this space, and that we're going to see more and more, even mainstream, you know, TV shows that get into this model when they see how successful Mario has been able to make it, you know? So I think he's really, really setting the stage for what we're going to see more and more in the future, and he's doing a brilliant job at it. I'm really proud of him.
Awesome. Azania Noah, thank you so much. Great to talk to you. So that's Azania Noah. You have to check her out on Facebook and on Periscope. She is a talented singer. You can probably tell because she's up for different gigs over in Europe and in the United States as part of musicals. So just definitely check her out. Just one of the talented people who comes out to be a part of the Never Settle Show and join this awesome studio audience. Really taking live streaming to another step, another level, by having a studio audience, a live band, in-person guests, wine bar, networking, caricaturist. Today there's going to be a mime because caricaturist Kathy Nolan is away. Integrating comments and everything from social media. Just an exciting, exciting event. The Never Settle Show with Mario Armstrong kicks off at 7 p.m. Eastern, on the Entrepreneur Magazine Facebook page, facebook.com/ENT Magazine. If you're just joining us, I am Ross Brand from livestreamuniverse.com, and we are meeting some of the cast, some of the people behind the scenes, some of the guests, and some of the attendees. And yeah, Chris Strub says I should draw. You don't want to see me draw any more than you would want to see me sing, okay? We are not going to draw. But thank you, Chris, for volunteering me. And yeah, it's awesome to see Azania. So we are getting ready now, the crowd coming in. Hey, Brad, great to see you. Hey to everybody who's watching us on the Never Settle Show Facebook page. Please do share this out. Let your friends know. A lot of great people here. We're going to continue doing interviews for a little bit and stay on. So definitely share this out. Let people know. And then we'll send everybody over to the Entrepreneur Facebook page at 7 p.m. Eastern for the show. I see Michael C. Voices is here. Yes, Michael, come on in. Good to see you, my friend.
Good to see
Michael
you. Hello,
Campbell,
everyone. Sorry.
The
Hello,
man
everyone.
With the golden voice, voiceover artist. Also, Michael, you're kind of the voice of the co-producers, kind of,
yes.
who can't
yes.
necessarily make it because they're too far away or whatever. And you've been coming every week to check out what's going on behind the scenes, to watch the show, to participate. What's your thoughts on the first 2 weeks? And now, after tonight, we'll be halfway through season one. Can you believe it?
Wow, I can't believe it. It's just been, this is like a dream come true. It's surreal. I mean, for the last year and a half to 2 years, we've been following Mario Armstrong on first on Periscope,
right.
Never Settled Club. And then the idea of this amazing show that he's been working on for 10 years, but right. watching it come to its fruition. And everything that I gained from that, I didn't know who Mario Armstrong was until I went on Periscope. I went actually followed Alex Pettit until he came to a summit in New York a couple of years ago. And then he introduced us to Mario Armstrong. I'm like, oh my goodness, Never Settle?
Right.
Going after your dreams and not letting anything get in your way? That's fantastic. And he's actually spending the time with us because he wants us to succeed. It's not enough for him to succeed no matter how... what it takes,
right.
because he's been on the Today Show and all the contacts and everything he's had. No, he says not compromising your morals or integrity. That's what he's done. He's wanted us to succeed with him. So since I'm able to go up on the train on the Jersey Shore, and I'm able to get here in about an hour and a half, other people are all over the country and all over the world. I'm here to be their physical presence here while they get to be online and interactive in this fantastic venue here. But I actually get to be here to show my enthusiasm and represent them.
Well,
and
it's great to see you and be able to hang out with you again for
fantastic.
A third straight week. This
yes,
is
this
awesome.
Is fantastic.
What is the feedback you're getting from the other people who were part of all the co-producers meetings and been following the development? What are you hearing from them about how they're enjoying the show and what they see happening?
Well, what I'm seeing is there's a group called NetFriending. There's another platform called Be Live that's out there. And other platforms are coming up. And the friends from this show and the followers from this show are starting their own platforms and their own shows based on friendship and helping each other. And it's just exponentially increasing. It's unbelievable. What starts out as a fantastic, wonderful idea for a show now has turned into these amazing friendships. And, you know, I mean, Zig Ziglar says you build people and people build a business. Well, you know what? That's the new type of networking, is net friending and becoming friends with people. Because when you have friends and the know, like, and trust factor, that's what the business is all about. And if you don't get, and if for nothing else, you have friendships. And watching this from week to week and watching how they tweak every part of this set and every part, the first show, there's no idea how it's actually going to come out as far as whether things are going to work, the interactive nature. But every time anything, the slightest thing went in one direction, they had three other things to cover it. It was almost like, yeah, we know exactly what's what's going to happen here. We know that. Oh my gosh, you know, it's a good thing that set went off over there, because we have these other three over here and two other things that wouldn't have happened if we had that.
Right, right.
And that's what the whole never settled life is about, and that's what the culture and the whole thought process is. You know, you take opportunities out of supposed setbacks.
Right, right.
So that's just amazing. It's great. And you are amazing.
You
set the stage. Ross Brand here sets the stage every single show with the red carpet. You know, absolutely A1 performance here.
Oh, thank you,
and
Michael.
You add a class to it that just takes it to a different level, even before the show starts, and even before the pre-show starts, when walking on the way to the Canary Studios.
Yeah, I did a pre-show for the pre-show.
Absolutely.
So, Michael, tell everybody where they can find you online if they're interested in voiceovers or just want to learn more.
Well, right now you can get me on Twitter at Michael C. Voice. Michael C. Voice or Michael C. Voices. I'm on
either
Facebook.
One.
Michael A. Campbell, or Michael A. Campbell on LinkedIn.
Awesome. Absolutely. Thank you, Michael.
Oh, thank you very much, Ross.
That is Michael C. Campbell. Michael A. Campbell is the name. It's Michael C. Voices, and he is a voiceover artist with an amazing, amazing voice. Definitely check him out. Don't forget that the Never Settle Show is coming up 7 p.m. Eastern on the Entrepreneur Facebook page, facebook.com/ENT Magazine. And as the crowd starts to file in, they're soon going to start to sit everybody down and get set for the show. I just want to thank everybody for joining us again. This has been a blast. We've talked to so many different people. If you enjoyed the show, we got time still between now and when Mario goes on the Entrepreneur Facebook page. So please do share this out and let people know. They can watch the pre-show and get excited for the show coming up at 7 p.m. Eastern. I think you know by now where to go. It's the Entrepreneur Facebook page, 7 p.m. Eastern, for the Never Settle Show presented by FedEx Office. Enjoy the show, everybody, and we'll talk to you later.